This lecture marks the beginning of my series on the principles of microeconomics. I will be introducing the concept of microeconomics, and economics in general, in order to give you a better idea of what exactly it is that we're trying to do when we analyze graphs, make predictions, etc. The syllabus for this lecture includes defining what exactly economics is, asking the basic economic questions, defining a new way of thinking, and taking a look at economics as a social science and a policy tool. Once you complete this lecture, I hope that you understand what economics is and why it is essential that everyone gain a basic understanding of how the economy works. Let's start off by defining what exactly economics is. Before doing that, I want to introduce two concepts, the first of which is scarcity. Scarcity is a very real problem that we as humans face. We can't have everything. We can't satisfy our unlimited wants because we only have a limited amount of resources. An incentive is a reward that encourages an action or a penalty that discourages another action. In economics, the most common incentive we see is price. Prices act as incentives for people to buy and for suppliers to sell. Now that we know what scarcity and incentives are, let's formally define economics. Economics is the social science that studies how society allocates scarce resources to satisfy unlimited wants. We look at the choices of individuals, governments, and entire societies as they choose what to do with their limited time, money, human capital, natural resources, etc. Economics is divided into two major categories, microeconomics and macroeconomics. Microeconomics is concerned with the study of choices that individuals and businesses make, while macroeconomics is concerned with the study of performance of the national and global economy. I like to use the analogy of a tree and a forest. A tree is an individual entity. If we study this tree, we are looking at a very small part of an entire forest. When we look at the entire forest, we take into account all the trees in the forest. We look at things in aggregates. The single tree is analogous to microeconomics, and the forest is analogous to macroeconomics.